6-year-old Ricky, he was most happy when he was with his crayons and his coloring books. And of course, his pup, Polo. He could spend hours and hours of time with his coloring books. One day he got very excited and he decided to draw his imaginary horse with his favorite superhero. When the drawing was completed, he felt elated, he felt excited, he wanted to show off, and he ran off to his brother Harry to show his masterpiece. Of course, he was excited, but what did Harry do? Harry laughed off his work. He said, "Your imaginary horse looks more like your pup." What happened to Ricky? Ricky, of course, was dejected. He was disappointed. He tried to make his drawing look right, but he could not. He finally gave up on his pens and his crayons and moved on with other aspects of his life.
So, good morning, everyone. I'm Samir and she's Harsha, and we are the founders and facilitators at Anybody Can Paint. So before we begin, I have a question for everyone in the room. How many of us believe that we cannot paint or draw? Say I. Fantastic. Let's do it once more. How many of us believe that we cannot paint or draw? Say I. Wow, that's a resounding I. And trust me, this is very natural and this is a very, very commonly held belief. Not just that, there are other beliefs like I am not creative. Only some people are born as artists. Art is bestowed only to the gifted few. When we reinitiated into this hobby of painting, we literally heard a lot of these statements from friends and people around in our social circles. Over a period, we've got really curious to find the source of such beliefs, why do they exist, and we wanted to craft a process to test their validity. So we did something interesting. One fine day on a weekend, we invited over a few friends, we blocked a nice room, we got all the art supplies, and we selected a beautiful painting. It seemed undoable. Our job was to create an enabling environment and provide the right support. We tested it out. And the results were really satisfying. It was fulfilling. It was outstanding. Everyone had a beautiful painting in their hands. It was like unbelievable. And folks enjoyed through the process. We went through the ups and downs, but it was really enjoyable. And even both of our joy knew no bounds. That was the moment when we felt that we had our true calling, which was to help everyone discover their hidden artists and spread the joy of painting to the world. It has been indeed a very rewarding journey for us and full of milestones. Like in this one, we just completed last week our 100th session of Anybody Can Paint. You could have never imagined. And for a fairly big audience. And since the last 2 years of our inception, more than 4,500 people have painted with us their maiden masterpieces. People who have never touched a brush since their childhood experiences.
So as we went on to this journey of Anybody Can Paint, our mission was primarily to create art for everybody by anybody. As we moved on, we realized that this art form was particularly called visual arts. Now this word visual arts, what does it mean? It means art which can be appreciated by eyesight. Now this term itself seemed very limiting to us. So what did we do? We decided to go for art beyond vision. Meet Afroz and Aishwarya. These are two spirited young ladies and we worked with them over the next few months. Now these young ladies actually lost their eyesight about 7 to 8 years back. In one of the sessions for which you see the visual, they actually painted alongside with us in a guided painting experience. Do not miss their smiles and their encouragement and the confidence which you see in them as they completed their small art pieces in a guided painting experience. The anybody can paint, art beyond vision actually spread its wings, and multiple people across diverse backgrounds who were visually impaired completed their masterpieces with us in an anybody can paint guided painting experience. This visual, of course, is very, very special for us. It's the same painting, it's the same format, same duration, and of course, as you can see, the output is also the same. The people at the top are software engineers from a top leading MNC. And the ones which you see in the bottom, these are 40 young girls, spirited ones, I must say, from the government blind school in Hyderabad. That is what true inclusion is what, of course, we felt. But really, what is true inclusion? True inclusion happens when we go beyond borders, we break boundaries, and we actually make everyone feel equal. This is one of our workshops, our public workshops, where everyone across diverse backgrounds came together and they painted this modern art. Of course, you can see the smiles on their faces, they enjoyed the experience, and the output was fantastic. But it's very easy for us to actually miss Aishwarya and Afroz, who participated as a part of this program and completed their own masterpieces alongside others. That's what we thought was true inclusion.
So let's take a pause, let's step back and explore how, when people believe that they cannot draw or paint, eventually end up making beautiful paintings. How does it happen? According to our research, it boils down to beliefs. Beliefs are those conclusions. Beliefs are those conclusions which we draw during our early, tender childhood. And they are shaped by the messages and experiences that we go through during that early childhood from the environment and the people around. All those instances when we received the I can messages help shape beliefs which are called empowering beliefs. And all those experiences or messages when we receive the I can't messages resulted in something called the limiting beliefs. And actually, I can't, these two words end up being the biggest limiting beliefs that exist in all of us. And it's just not these messages, but it's also those experiences which help shape our belief systems at that tender age. For example, if we were to ask Riti to try a painting or try a drawing again, that individual will have an association with the painful process of being laughed at if he attempts to draw again. So, most probably, that individual will avoid getting into painting again. So the question is, what do we do to break free from these limiting beliefs and replace them with what we call empowering beliefs in our adult lives and open doors for endless possibilities? Is there a magical switch? Well, it is. The magical switch is air. It's a simple three-step process. First, we have to acknowledge the limiting belief. Then we have to invest resources, time, and effort in an I can experience. And the result will be rescripting of new empowering beliefs in our mindset. And anybody can paint, the entire experience is nothing but an I can experience which we have been honored to have been able to create and offer. And based on the kind of limiting belief that we have, we can have the power to select and craft our own I can experience and validate and test it and rescript a new belief system in us. So for example.
So let me just take a pause here and share my own personal story and relate back to air. So from the time I remember, I was always obese. And I had this interesting belief in my mind that obese people can never lose weight. Now, as I moved forward in my own journey along with him and we realized the power of anybody can paint and what makes people do what they think they cannot do, I thought that I need to reflect back and see if I could apply it to my own personal area as well. So, while in the past I had tried multiple times to lose weight, but I would always not be able to succeed. I realized, when I reflect back now, I realized that it was more a sequencing issue, if I may call it. Because I was working on my body, but I had not worked on my mind. So what did I do? So I thought that let me craft an I can experience to challenge that limiting belief I had in me. So what did I do? I did a very simple step. I enrolled for a very small, crisp fitness program, 2-week fitness program. And the goal there was, of course, not to become fit, because if I'm as obese as you see in the picture, I cannot become fit in 2 weeks. But the goal was more to challenge that belief and see if I could lose some weight. So I did that. I lost about 2.5 kgs in 2 weeks of time. And that thought became liberating for me, that yes, I can challenge that belief, I can create an experience for myself, and of course, it will require perseverance, it will require hard work, it will require focus, it will require determination, but yes, I will be able to do it. So with that mindset and that confidence, I moved forward, and I was actually able to shed 30 kgs in 6 months of time. So of course, my confidence level grew leaps and bounds, as you can see. But at the same time, I felt, what more can I do? The possibilities just became limitless. At this point, I am actually a certified fitness coach, and my whole vision is to inspire others to go through the same journey, for them to be able to create and craft those I can experiences for themselves, and open up those limitless possibilities which exist. So that's definitely a personal story where I have been able to apply air.
All right. So are we all ready for experiencing an I can experience right now over here? All right. So let's get in. Let's shift gears. So I would request all of you to grab a sheet of paper and a pencil which has been provided to you. Just follow through the instructions and enjoy the experience.
So we really encourage each one of you to try this. Trust me.
All right.
Not regret.
So let's start by making a vertical line on the sheet of paper. The length doesn't matter. Let's draw a simple vertical line on the paper. Second, let's divide it into 2 equal halves. Fantastic. Now let's draw a line across this half mark, a horizontal line across this half mark, which should be slightly smaller than the vertical line. Let's say roughly 40% smaller than the vertical line. Now let's divide this horizontal line into 5 equal parts by making 4 equidistant points. I will show you over here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And you have 5 equal parts on this horizontal line. Next, between the first 2 points, let's make a flat curve on the top. Let's draw a flat curve at the bottom. Perfect. Let's make a similar flat curve on the other 2 dots and a flat curve on the bottom of the other 2 dots. Brilliant. Let's make 2 semicircles on the upper sides of these 2 figures that we have just created. And as you can see, 2 eyes are starting to pop out of the sketch. Let's shade these eyes, but leave a small little white circle inside it unshaded. So let's shade the 2 areas, but leave 1 small little white circle unshaded in it. Now it gets interesting. Let's draw a small curved line above the eyes, very, very close to the eyes. That's the eye fold. Now time for the eyebrows. Slightly above the eye, let's make an eyebrow on both the sides and darken it a bit to give it some form. Wow. Wonderful. Now let's focus on the lower half of the vertical line. Let's divide it into half. Just above this half mark of the bottom vertical line, let's make a lower curve for the nose tip. Now let's darken the end points of this curve for the nostrils. All right, a curve on the right and a curve on the left. Let's add the nose bridge with a curved wavy line going all the way to the center of the eyes from both the sides. Now just below the half mark, let's make a V. Simple V. Let's stretch a line for the upper lip going all the way up till the midpoint of the pupil. Up till the midpoint of the pupil on both the sides. Join the two ends of this mouth with a more or less curved straight line. Let's join the two dots again with a deeper lower lip line. Now we are getting close. Now it's time for the ears. So where the eye line, the horizontal eye line ended, from there let's drop two ears, two curves all going all the way out, and bring it down to the nose level, the tip of the nose level. Now it's the time for the jawbone. So let's start from the end of the ear, draw a curve for the jawbone and connect it to the chin, and do it the same way from the other side. We are coming close. The last thing is adding the outer hairline. It's easy. Let's start with the midpoint of the ear and bring a curve all the way up, joining to the topmost crown part of the head. Similarly, on the other side, let's drop a line, curved line, all the way from the top, connecting to the right midpoint of the other ear. Let's split the hair for this individual somewhere on the right side of the head. For the inner hairline, let's run a line parallel across the forehead, bring it down all the way to the sideburn. And similarly on the right side, bring the hairline curve down, bring it all the way to the sideburn. And you can see a face of a young man popping up. But what's more interesting, let's play little bit with this figure. Let's imagine this individual when this individual grows old and reaches maybe 65 plus age, what changes we would see? First, we would see the outside jawbone becoming slightly more enlarged. Similarly, on both the sides, the outside jawbone becoming a little more enlarged. The inside jawbone will also have two curves like this from both the sides. There would be a more prominent cheekbone coming all the way from here, going down and appearing here. two lines under both the eyes. More prominent cheek muscles. Let's do our last bit to this individual. Let's give him a French beard. And we are getting close. Let's add a spectacle on this face. So the temple comes like a slanting line from the sides, the temple of the spectacles. Let's draw the glasses big. Let's give him a big set of glasses around both the eyes. And make the frame of the glasses slightly thicker so you can shade a bit on it. Last, let's shade the hair. And let's make it interesting. Let's get the hair cover half of the top part of the ears. So a thicker sideburn, and let's darken the area of the hair. If you want, you can do some shading for the French beard for the individual. And you would see that a common celebrity, a popular superstar emerging all the way from our sketch. All right, so raise up your drawing and show it to your neighbors.
So what we experienced just now is actually an I can experience. From being in a state of I can't draw, I can't paint, each one of you have a small victorious drawing in your hands. Do we? So there is a Ricky in all of us, if you remember the caricature. In fact, our caricature of Ricky is inspired by multiple participants who've attended our workshops across various sessions and have completed their masterpieces and have explored their I can experiences. All it just requires is air. Acknowledge your past, invest in your present, and reinforce, re-script your future. Thank you.
Thank you.